everyone, welcome to Lectures by Aparna. This is the part 1 video of Programmable Logic Devices or PLDs. Here we will see an introduction to PLDs and a type of PLD or Programmable Logic Device, that is Programmable Logic Array, PLA. This is a type of PLD and we will see about it in detail. So let us see what is a logic device. A logic device will perform a definite logical function. A definite logical function which is decided at the time of manufacture and will never change. For example, a NOT gate. This is a NOT gate. Let A be the input given to it and at the output we get the inverted input. Inverted form of the input we will get at the output. So it will just do the invert operation. An IC which contains NOT gates will become a logic device and you can use this device in circuits. On the other hand, what is a programmable logic device? They are also ICs. So PLDs are logic devices that can be programmed to perform particular logical functions by the user depending on the need. They can also change it into another logic function at a later point of time. That is, these are reconfigurable. But their flexibility, it will depend on what type of PLD they are. So there are three fundamental types of programmable logic devices. They are, first one is PLA or programmable logic array. Second one is PAL or programmable array logic. Third one is PROM, that is programmable read only memory. Programmable logic devices or PLDs, they are typically built with an array of AND gates and an array of OR gates like this. So this is the array of AND gates. This is called the AND array and this is the OR array. And these are the inputs and these are the outputs. The cut means that there are many input-output lines. Depending on whether the AND array or the OR array, whichever is programmed, they are classified into these three types. For PROM or programmable read-only memory, AND array is fixed and OR array is programmable. That is, you can program only the OR array. For PAL, the AND array is programmable and the OR array is fixed. You can program only the AND array. For PLA, for programmable logic array, this is the programmable logic array. Both the AND array and the OR array can be programmed. So PLA is the most flexible. It is the most flexible type of programmable logic device. Now what is the advantage of using PLDs? The problem of using ICs which contain separate logic gates like NAND gate IC, NOR gate IC, etc. is that in the logic design, when we place them, they require lots of circuit board space. Also, they need a great deal of time and also cost in inserting, soldering and testing them. But if you use PLDs, you are having some advantages. These are the advantages of using PLDs. They take lesser board space, they are faster, they are having less costly assembly processes, and they are having higher reliability because only fewer number of ICs will be needed, and this will make the circuit connections and troubleshooting easier. So these are some of the advantages of using PLDs or programmable logic devices. Now let us see the first type of PLD, that is PLA or programmable logic array, in detail. You can see that for PLA, both AND array and OR array can be programmed. Now let us see how to implement Boolean functions using PLA. Consider the Boolean function F1 is equal to AB bar plus AC plus A bar BC bar, and F2 equal to AC plus BC. So here we need three inputs A, B and C. A, B, C are the inputs and two outputs, that is F1 and F2. They are the outputs. This circuit is too small to be commercially available, but it is presented here to make the explanation easier. So the first thing you have to do is pass the inputs A, B, C through a buffer and an inverter, so that you will get A bar, B, B bar, C, C bar. So let's draw that circuit. This is just a symbol to show that here you get the inverted signal and here you get the original signal. Now each input and its complement, they have to be connected to AND gates. Here total 4 product terms are there. That is AB bar is there, then AC is there, then BC is there, and A bar BC bar is there. So total 4 AND gates are needed. You can draw it like this. The product term is determined from the inputs whose cross points are marked by an into sign. So to get A B bar here, you have to cross at A and B bar. So A is here, B bar is here. Next, to get AC, you have to cross at A and C. C is here. Next, to get BC, you have to cross at B and C. And next is A bar BC bar. You have to cross at A bar B and C bar. Now from these outputs of AND gates, we have to connect to the inputs of OR gates. So these will go to the inputs of first OR gate, and these will go to the inputs of second OR gate. Now at the output of first OR gate, you have to get the function F1 equal to AB bar plus AC plus A bar BC bar. So we have to mark at AB bar, AC and A bar BC bar here for the first OR gate. So you get at the output of first OR gate F1 equal to AB bar plus AC plus A bar BC bar. Now for the second OR gate, the term is F2 equal to AC plus BC. That is, you have to mark at AC and BC. So at output of second OR gate, you get F2 is equal to AC plus BC. So these will go to the inputs of the second OR gate. So we got the functions F1 and F2 using a PLA. This is how you implement Boolean functions using PLA or programmable logic array. See, here we have programmed both AND array and the OR array. So to do this programming, it is very important to make the PLA programming table. It is called PLA programming table. So we will see how we can write the PLA programming table. This is a PLA programming table. It consists of three sections: product terms, inputs and outputs. In the first column, I have to write all the product terms, that is AB bar, AC, BC and A bar, BC bar. In the second column, you have to mark the values of each input that makes a product term. So you can fill it like this. For AB bar, in AB bar, A is 1, B is 0. In the place of C, we'll put a dash because variable C is not there here. So we put a dash here. For AC, A is 1, C is 1, B is not there. So we put a dash. Next, for BC, B is 1, C is 1, A is not there. And for A bar, BC bar, A is 0, B is 1, C is 0. Now in the third column, that is the output column, you have to fill for F1 and F2. So F1 will be 1 at AB bar. See, in F1, the term AB bar is there. So you put a 1 here. Next, in F1, which all functions, product terms are there? AC is there. So you put a 1 here. BC is not there. So we put a dash here. Next term is A bar, BC bar. We put a 1 here. Now for F2, it is AC plus BC. So AB bar is not there. AC is there. So I put a 1 here. Next, BC is there, I put a 1 here. A bar, BC bar is not there. So I put a dash here. So this is how you fill the PLA programming table. Let us consider the variable A. Let us consider this variable A. A equal to 1 means that a connection is taken from A to the AND gate. A equal to 0. A equal to 0 means that connection is taken from A bar to the AND gate. A equal to a dash means a blown fuse in both the input variable and its complement at those points. That is at A bar and A. So PLA is of two types. That is mask programmable and field programmable. This is mask programmable and this is field programmable. With mask programming, the user gives his PLA programming table to the manufacturer. This table will then be used by them to produce the custom-made PLA that has the required internal logic specified by the customer. So this is done by blowing the internal fuses at required points. Whereas field programmable can be done by the user himself by means of a hardware programming unit. So these are some of the concepts about PLAs or programmable logic arrays. If this video has helped you, please do subscribe to my channel. Also, don't forget to like and share this video. Thank you.